Stay. Stay. There you go. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another, this is like, what, 4 or 5 days in a row of good weather. Can't remember the last time it rained, almost looking for rain. Wish the temperature would drop just a bit. All that summer stuff that we start feeling, right? But that's okay. I don't mind it one bit. And I also noticed, too, that a lot of people are mentioning on Facebook and social media of all sorts of things, how they're getting ready to go away for the long weekend tomorrow. But I thought Monday was the holiday. You know, I don't know if I want to have an appointment tomorrow anywhere, specifically with a doctor or anyone of that thing. I just got a feeling that they're not. No one's really thinking much about it's going to be a holiday, May 24th weekend. And you know what they say, don't ever plant before then, eh? And every year I keep on thinking, well, yeah, look, it's really nice. And sure enough, you would get a cold spell. So wait till the 24th, right till the 24th. Just a little bit of advice from a guy who doesn't grow anything. Well, I can, you know, just looking at plants that die. Anyway, enough of my life. Well, the showroom, we're doing quite well. I know there's some people here tonight for the first time. That's very cool. Just to let you know, you're sitting in seats that came from the Jehovah Witnesses in Souk, whom I actually met the person a week ago, came to a concert, and she moved into the building where the seats had been before we had them. Right? So, like, the story just gets, it's, you never go far, eh? Anyway, and then if you took a look, I don't know if any of you got a chance to walk into the back, but I found a... online, we have a puppet show. It's a huge puppet show, constructed thing, 4 pieces. You know, it's quite huge, quite big, and quite functional. And it came from the New Life Baptist Church. So that's like 2 major things in my life that are going to be, changing my life majorly. Both come from organized religion. Don't ever put that away. Organized religion is good. Especially when you get rid of things, and I'm in line. And one of the things we were in line for tonight was that this gentleman, Tony McManus, was in the area. So the man plays much larger venues and plays much larger towns, but he was in the opportunity to be in here. And it's really nice because we got him a bed and breakfast overlooking the ocean, right? Out in Maple Bay, and that's kind of nice. So it's setting for a really nice evening. He's very comfortable. He's tried our Thai food up the street from Sai's. Yes, I know he's in a good mood now. And you, the audience, are the only part that has to make it better, any better than what it's going to be. So sit back and with warm welcome, please, Tony McManus to the stage.
Thank you very much. I came just for the intro. That was excellent. How are you doing? It's nice to see some of you are still here. The Thai food was fabulous too. I'm going to start with a couple of jigs. Is that okay? And we'll see where it goes from there, all right? Thank you. Thank you very much. There were two jigs, as I said. The first one written by a woman called Emer Mayock. Thank you so much. Emer is from County Mayo in Ireland, and she plays flute and fiddle. No, not at the same time. And the tune is called Kaliana, and I have absolutely no idea what that word means. It means something in a foreign language, other than Irish. And the second tune is from Montreal, written by a banjo-playing lawyer. What a great combination. I think the world would be a better place if all lawyers were forced to play the banjo. Don't you think? That was a tune called Le Tourmont. I've been doing this for 25 years. I've yet to figure out how to work a mic stand. There, we're good. I was too fond of walking, and when you said you'd reach the sky, I thought it was your way of talking, but you said you'd build some wings. You found out how it could be done. I was doubtful of everything. I never thought you'd reach the sun. Watch you for hours with the glue and the rubber bands, the feathers and the lace and the flowers, the finished wings, they glowed so bright, like some old bird of glory began to envy you your flight, like some old hero. Tried always to dare me, but when I looked at the skies so blue, I thought the height would scare me, but I carried your wings for you. Up the path and to the cliff face, kissed you goodbye and watched your eyes already bright. Watch you soaring higher, but there was a pain in my heart. Your wings seemed tipped with fire, like some seagull or a lark, soaring forever, or some ember or a spark, drifting from earth. I believed all that you had said. I believed all that you told me. You'd do a thing no man had ever done. You touched the stars to please me, but as I watched your white wings fail, I saw your feathers falter, and I watched you drop like a ball of gold into the wide green. Some are born to follow, and some are born to touch the sky, and some walk in the hollow. But as I watched your body fall, I knew really you had won me, your grave was not the earth, but the reflection of the very much. Any listeners? Thank you. Well, we have another stool and a couple of microphones on the stage, so let's get them fired up. Please welcome to the stage Miss Julia Toasbjorn. Julia's from Berlin. You know, we did a tour last year in New England, and I would introduce Julia as being from Berlin, and they'd say, oh yeah, Berlin, Connecticut? No, it's all Berlin, New Hampshire. No. She's from the big Berlin. We're going to play a tune called The Maids of Mitchellstown, which is nowhere near Berlin. Duncan for that matter. This is a slowed down reel. This is a dance tune for a low gravity environment. So if you can imagine a Kaylee dance on the moon or up in the space station, you would need. And it's much better in tune. There we go.
All right.
The Maids of Mitchellstown. Thank you. Thank you very much. So we will continue our exploration of the Celtic lands by going to Nashville. Known with great affection. This is a tune written by my buddy Russ Barenberg. Great bluegrass picker. A tune called Through the Gates, and after that, a tune from Manchester, England.
Thank you. going to do a song of mine, and it's called Penny. It comes from the saying, a penny for your thoughts. When I sing the song in Germany, in my home country, I have to translate that saying. It goes, ein Königreich für deine Gedanken. And it doesn't mean a penny for your thought, it means a kingdom for your thoughts, in German.
We're going to do the Scottish version, it's just a penny.
Tony has a very nice little Scottish small guitar.
How many of you play guitar? Two people, three, four. Is that it? Oh, okay. This is a G on the headstock. This is a Michael Greenfield guitar from Montreal. Michael makes, I don't know, I think 15 guitars a year, and they're all gone, even before they're made. He has a waiting list of about 3 years. So this is what happens when you order a Greenfield guitar and you don't keep up the payments. He comes to your home and he shrinks the guitar. So this is a Scottish Greenfield.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's not learning, this mic stand. So let me play one more on this. A little beauty. If I can change the tuning. There we are. One of my first trips to Canada, back in 1998, I made a record in Joliet, in Quebec, just north of Montreal, and the engineer was a wonderful man called André Marchand, who was one of the founder members of La Patine Surreal, one of the best bands ever. And André doesn't write that many tunes, but every one he does is a classic. And this is one of his. It's called Le Matin de Bonnie Doon, Mornings at Bonnie Doon. And that sounds as if it should be in Scotland. Bonnie Doon. It's a Robert Burns song, The Banks and Braes of Bonnie Doon. This Bonnie Doon is in California, alas. It's in Santa Cruz. And we have a mutual friend there, André and I, a man called Paul Hosterer. And he sat, André was visiting, and he sat outside Hosterer's house. He lives in the Redwood Forest, just north of Santa Cruz. These beautiful, gigantic, thousand-year-old trees. And he said to me, "Oh, Tony, I sat there drinking my cafe, and the muse, she come to visit me. And I composed the tune in as long as it take to play." Great, because it's a beautiful tune. So the next time I was at Paul Hosterer's house in Bonnie Doon, I sat underneath the very same tree. And I waited, and waited, and waited. So here's André's tune. Le Matin de Bonnie Doon. And then a Strathspey, a tune, a Scottish tune, from James Scott Skinner called The Laird of Drumblair. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you. Now, we'll carry on with this little beast. Two waltzes from Brittany. Have you been to Brittany? Ooh, a handful. Good. They have a drink there called Shushen. I'm willing to try anything once. It was a W.C. Fields that would try anything once, except incest and folk dancing. That's the truth, he said that. So I was in Brittany and was offered a glass of Shushen. A belt of Shushen. This stuff is made from bees, not honey. It's made from bees. And after the second mouthful, I realized why it's illegal. I'm a very liberal kind of guy. I'm in favor of legalizing everything except Shushen. Evil stuff. But I love Brittany. I have lots of musical friends there. And these tunes are written by Jackie Mollard. And they're called La Valsonette et La Valse des Pastoriaux. So, La Valsonette and the Shepherd's Waltz. Thank you. We're going to do one more for you in this half. Julia on fiddle. Three jigs. First is called The Humours of Kilty Clocker. Kilty Clocker is in the County Leitrim. And we'll go from there to Kilfenora, which is in, don't make me do all the work now, where? Kilfenora, County Clare. And we'll finish up a tune written by a guy called John Carty, called the Shaunavac Tube Station. And we'll take a break after these. There's a handful of CDs right over there, I believe. Should you be interested in any way, shape, or form in those, they're there. There we go. Thank you.
needed was the audience to be that major part. Well, you guys did a real good job. So let's do it again and get Tony McManus back to the stage.
Thank you. Yeah, that's all true. Is this your first time as an audience? You did very well. Someone was asking at the interval, sorry, you're still using those tortoise shell picks? Those illegal, contraband, genuine tortoise shell picks. The answer is no, if you work for Canada Customs. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was a piece by a guy called Isaac Guillory. Isaac was an American guitar player. The only person I'd ever met who'd been to Guantanamo Bay in Cuba, because he was born there. His father was in the US Navy. So he grew up all over the place. And eventually he made his way over to England in the 70s and stayed. So I used to go and see Isaac every chance I got, and I would sit making mental notes as to how he did stuff and then run off home and work on it. Amazing player. I'm going to carry on with the set of tunes that starts out in Limerick. I should have a limerick to introduce this set of tunes. I'll work on that on the flight home. Then the next time we're in Duncan, I will introduce a set of tunes. There was a young jig from Limerick. But it goes from a slow air into a jig, into a slip jig, into, and we'll finish. We'll start in Limerick and we'll finish in Cape Breton. With a tune called Hull's Reel. John Morris Rankin. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Julia's back.
Thank you. She gives me back my own pick. Thank you. We're going to play some more tunes from Brittany. There's a kind of mafia in Breton music, in the sense that there's lots and lots and lots of bands. There's Cornog and Guers and Den and Bazaz and all these different Breton bands, but they're all the same people. There's only two guitar players in the whole of Brittany, Swag Sibril and Gilles de Bigot. Pick any band, one of them will be the guitar player. There's only two fiddle players, Jacques Mollard and Christian Lemaitre. There's only one flute player, Jean-Michel Villon. There's only one bass player, Alain Gentil. So, come on in. Swag, Breton French, I don't know. Swag is short for Jean-François. How? I don't know. He's a great composer of tunes. Great player too. So he wrote these two ditties. The first one is a thing called Sweet Rain, of which we've had precious little on this trip, thankfully. And then a kind of schizophrenic jig, a tune called the Plevan jig. First part is in 6/8, for those of you tapping your feet and taking notes. First part is in 6/8, second part is in 9/8. So it's a cross between a slip jig and a jig. There was probably Shushan involved.
Fussy.
Thank you very much. We're going to do that rarity in Scottish music, which is a love song with a happy ending. You probably know the Scots and romance are not, let's say, occasional bedfellows, but no more. I made this record recently with Beppe Gambetta, who's a wonderful guitar player from Genoa, Italy. So we spent a lot of time in the car. Lots of time to yammer away about everything under the sun, comparing Italian culture and Scottish culture. Why is that immediately funny? Food, for example, would be an area of difference. The Italians arguably have the edge. Haggis is wonderful. It's the best. We were talking about haggis earlier. It's one of these things where I wouldn't, for $1 million, eat any of the individual ingredients, but if you combine it together, yes. Especially if it's drizzled with single malt, which is the only way to have haggis. I want to get a t-shirt that says, Scottish cuisine, it's to die from. And anyway, so that would be one area of difference. Another would be romance, I guess. The Italians may have an edge over the Scots, over the bog trotters. We were thinking, you know, maybe an Italian lover would gently stimulate their partner with a feather, you know, tickling erotically the appropriate areas, whereas a Scottish lover would use the entire chicken. And just go steaming straight in. There you go. Have a bit of that. Yeah, well, it's a different approach. So anyway, this is, with that in mind, here is a Scottish love song, which involves no poultry whatsoever. There is a mention of ousen, sheep, and kye. Kye is horse, as cows. Ousen, oxus. Sheep and Kai. Anyway, this is called Bonnie Jean. And they all loved happily ever after. You get that in the last line, love was aye between them all. Aye means always, as well as yes. It's a very confusing language, Lowland Scots. But we'll take you on a little trip.
Since she was fair at Kirkin Market to be seen, and all her fairest maids were mad, flew o'er them Bonnie Jean. Aye, she rocked her country well, and she sang so joyfully, the bonniest bird upon the bough had not a lighter heart than she. Hawks will rob the tender joy that bless the lint white nest. Frost will blight the fairest flower. Love will break the soundest rest. For she met a braw young man, the pride of Wise Glen. He and I horses, 9 or 10. The lad took Ginny to the train and danced the lassie on and down. Bang her witless Ginny was, her heart was tint, her peace was down. As in the bosom o' the stream, the moon dwelt a dewy heen. So trembling pure was tender love within the breast of Bonnie Jean. The bird sang sweeter love, flowers bloom on the day. As close to her he often lay and whispered this his tender tale. Oh, Jeannie fair, I love thee, dear, and will ye gang wi' me? I'll leave your parents here, and nothing else will trouble thee. So what could helpless Jeannie do? She had nae wit to tell him no. At length she blushed her sweet consent, and love was aye between them two.
Thank you very much. There you go. Well, bye then. I'll play something with a lot fewer notes than some of the other stuff we play. I got an email from a fellow called Neil Jordan, who's a film director from Ireland. Have any of you seen The Crying Game?
Yeah.
He did that. Interview with the Vampire? Yes. Michael Collins, yeah, fantastic biopic. The Sound of Music, not many people know. Anyway, he was making a film in Ireland called Ondine. And he wanted a bunch of my music on the soundtrack of this film, and took a couple of album tracks and then flew me over to Dublin to see what they'd done with it. And and then he would send stuff to me, little snippets of music, and I would work on them and demo things and send them over to Dublin, and he would send comments to me, and back and forth it would go. And he sent this one piece and said, could you arrange this for steel string guitar? Of course, no problem. I had no idea what I was doing. This is a piece of late 19th century French romantic piano music by Eric Satie. Now, I grew up in Paisley, Scotland in the 1970s. There wasn't a lot of Eric Satie in our house. At that time it was mostly Rachmaninoff in the McManus house. And the Chieftains.
Anyway.
I did. I arranged it and sent it over to Ireland, and I got this lovely message back saying, it's beautiful, it's gorgeous, it's the right length, the right vibe, the right everything. And the film came out, and they didn't use it. But they used Pat Metheny instead. But that's okay. I'm a huge fan of Pat's. And he was playing a Linda Manzer guitar. My good friend Linda from Toronto. So it's all right in the end. Anyway, so this started a whole process, and I ended up making a whole album of classical and Baroque music done in my own sweet, uneducated, boneheaded way. And there was music by Bach and Couperin and Monteverdi and Eric Satie and Enrique Granados and a whole bunch of other people. But this is the hit single. You look like the kind of audience who may be old enough to remember hit singles. You meet people nowadays who've never heard of albums. Anyway, this is Eric Satie's Nocien number one. Thank you. Thank you.
I should do another one. It's a lovely thing, the live fade out. You have to be very careful. My friends in Brittany, I saw them do this at a gig in Germany, and the sound guy didn't get it at all. He just kept pushing the faders up. Thinking there was something going wrong. A big hand for Tim on sound. Back to Scotland. This is it's called the sleeping tune. A wonderful lullaby written for the Highland bagpipes. Written by Gordon Duncan. Here we go. Thank you. you.
Thank you. So, some more fiddle tunes.
Three tunes in this set. All written by fiddlers. We're going to start in Cape Breton. A tune by Jerry Holland. Called Stan Chapman's Jig. And then we're heading to the Hebrides, to the island of Islay. Tune called the Isla Ranters Reel. And we're going to finish in Philadelphia, a great hotbed of Celtic culture. I always thought, it's a tune called Wissahickon Drive, which I for years thought was in Chicago, because it was written by Liz Carroll, great Chicago fiddle player. And actually, there's a really cool video, you should check this out, of John Doyle and Liz Carroll playing at the White House on Paddy's Day. And I don't know who took the video, but anyway, there's loads of people in sharp suits mingling around, and there's Liz and John tearing the arse out of these tunes, playing brilliantly. The only person listening to them is President Obama. And then there's my friend Billy McComiskey, who was asked to play this year at the White House and said no. Thank you. I couldn't agree more. Actually, he said a lot more than no, but it amounted to no. So, three fiddle tunes. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. What a great pleasure it's been to come here to Duncan and play for you. We're going to finish up with three tunes from Spain, from the north of Spain, from the province of Asturias. Generally, when people think of Celtic music in Spain, it's Galicia, which is 10 times bigger and arguably prettier. It has Santiago de Compostela, a beautiful city, and Vigo in the south, and La Coruña in the north, and it's beautiful. Next door is Asturias, which is a lot smaller. And the music from there is wonderful and completely different to Galician music. It differs in huge ways that are only readily apparent to Asturians. But the worst thing you can do is mistake Galician music for Asturian music, particularly to a bunch of musicians from Asturias. They get very irate. So we're going to play three very definite Asturian tunes to finish. Thank you all very much for coming out. Hopefully we'll come back when it's not holiday weekend and the weather's shit. Yeah, is that possible? Anyway, thank you very much. We've had a great time. Great time tuning.
Good.
Thank you.
You're too kind. There's nowhere to go back there. So here we are. Thank you very much. So yeah, it's been a fairly manic trip from Fergus, Ontario, to Toronto, to Vancouver, to Portland, Oregon, to La Conner, Washington, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, then Sunday evening, gig in Seattle and Vancouver, and then Penticton, and then we were in Harrison, Hot Springs last night. Way! And up at the crack of dawn to get to Wasson. To the ferry. And over here to, where are we? So we're both a bit knackered. So I'm gonna send you home with a couple of tunes that involve almost no movement at all. Three lazy jigs, ideal for this time of night. So thank you very much. There's still a handful of CDs, if the mood takes you. First one is called Out in the Ocean, as we were this morning. So just watch these two fingers. Don't watch this end.
There we go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Safe home.
Thank you.
Hearts, lovers, love in fits and starts. Passion plays.